In this video, we're going to grade the quiz that you just took. I'm looking at problem number one. It tells tell whether triangle ABC and XYZ could be similar. Well, we know two things about similar. For figures to be similar, their corresponding angles are equal. And number two, their corresponding sides are proportional. Here was the big thing for us. We know that similar means proportional. Similar means proportional. They are dilations of one another. It's like a blown up picture. The question is, are these two similar? Well, you can see that this side 6 corresponds with this side 3. This side 6 corresponds with this side 3. This side 8 corresponds with this side 4. Are those indeed proportional? Well, yes, they are. If you took this figure here and multiplied by a scale factor of 1/2, you would get all of these values. 6 times 1/2 is 3. 6 times 1/2 is 3. 8 times 1/2 is 4. Since they all have that same multiplier, these are indeed similar. We could also set up a proportion and verify that. I could say 6 over 3 is equal to 6 over 3. Well, we can clearly see that. That's the same fraction. 8 over 4. Indeed, these two fractions are equal. 6 over 3 is 2. 8 over 4 is 2. I can also verify with a cross multiplication. 3 times 8 is 24. 6 times 4 is 24. 24 is equal to 24. This statement is also true. Therefore, these two triangles are indeed similar. Number 2. Tell whether triangle ABC and triangle XYZ are similar. The measure of the corresponding angles are equal. Well, we know the corresponding angles are equal. We just need to see, are the sides equal? Well, you see here 12 goes to 4. That's multiplied by 1/3. So the rest must multiply by 1/3. 15 to 5, that's times 1/3. But 20 to 7 is not times 1/3. Indeed, these are not similar. I will use my proportion to verify. 20 corresponds with 7. Is that equal to 12 corresponds with 4? We want to see, is this an equivalent proportion? Again, 20 corresponds with 7. You can see they're in the same spot. 12 corresponds with 4. 20 over 7 equal to 12 over 4. Let's see if they are indeed equal. Well, 20 times 4 is 80. 7 times 12, that is 84. Indeed, 20 is not equal to 84. This statement is false. Thus, this statement is false. Thus, indeed, these two are not similar. 2 is B as in boy. Number 3. The measures of the corresponding angles are equal and the opposite sides are equal. We want to tell whether these two are similar. Same situation. We will simply set up a proportion. 12 corresponds with 9. 8 corresponds with 6. 12 over 9 equals 8 over 6. Are those indeed equal? Well, 6 times 12 is 72. 9 times 8 is 72. They are equal. This is true. So this is true. Thus, these two figures are similar. To get from 12 to 9, we would multiply by 4 over 3. Same thing from 8 to 6. 12 over 9 and 8 over 6 are equivalent fractions. They both reduce to 4/3. Number 3 is B as in boy. Number 4. We want to tell whether they are similar. Again, we're looking for, are they the same proportion? This one's pretty easy to see without setting up the proportion. 18 to 9, how does that happen? Times 1 half. We just want to see, are all the other sides times 1 half? 14 times 1 half will give 7. 14 times 1 half will give 7. 22 times 1 half will give 11. These two figures are similar. Number 4 is B as in boy. Right. Number 5, it says triangle ABC, similar, that symbol means similar, to triangle XYZ. Find XY. We're looking for question mark. Well, we're going to set up a proportion again. 15 corresponds with 10. 12 corresponds with question mark. I will make my proportion. 15 over 10 equals 12 over question mark, changing question mark to the arbitrary variable x. Now I will cross multiply. 10 times 12 is 120. 15 times x is 15x. Dividing both sides by 15. X equals, dividing 120 by 15, that will be 8. X is 8. The answer on number 5 is A. 5 is A. All right, number 6. Get to the question sentence, which says, what is the length of the base? We're looking for the base, X here. Says the front of Jane's house is similar in shape to Spot's doghouse. We know they're similar, so they're proportional. Well, if this side is 10, we know that this side is 10. So, 40 to 10, how does that happen? It's 1/4 as much. So the question is, what number 1/4 would give 9? Said another way, 10 times what gives 40? Well, 10 times 4. Thus, 9 times that same 4 will give x to be 36. X is 36. The correct answer on 6 is C. Let's set up a proportion to find that. We don't know this value x. 40 corresponds with 10. 40 corresponds with 10. 40 over 10 equals x over 9. X over 9. All right, before I do my cross multiplication, let me do a divide here. Divide, divide. 1 times x is x. 9 times 4 is 36. X is indeed 36. Number 6 is C. Number 7 we omitted. Number 8 says find the circumference of the circle to the nearest tenth. We have the formula. Circumference is equal to pi times the diameter, or also 2 pi times radius, because we know that the diameter is 2 radius. We see these two formulas are really the same. In this case, they're giving us the radius. So circumference equals 2 pi r. Circumference equals 2 pi is 3.14, and my radius is 17. All right. I want 2 times 3.14 times 17. Multiplying 2 times 17, we get 34. So here we have 34 times 3.14. Before I go multiplying, I'm going to seek reasonableness. Well, 3 times 33 would be 100. So 3.14 times 34 is going to be close to 100. It's going to be D, even before I go and do this multiplication. 9, this is way too much. That's too little. And that's too much. This has to be close to 100. Here I go. 4 times 4 is 16. Carry my 1. 4 times 3 is 12, and 1 is 13. Introduce the 0. Done with that one. 4, 3. Done with this one. Introducing 2 zeros. 3 times 4, 12. Carry my 1. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 1 is 10. Summing 6, 7, 6. I have 106.76, and that is indeed very close to 106.8. Number 8 is D. Number 9. Find circumference. Again, circumference is equal to pi times diameter. They tell us the diameter is 32. Circumference is equal to 32. That's my diameter times pi, 3.14. All right, again, I'm going to go with reasonableness. 3 times 32 is 96. It's going to have to be 100. Multiplying 32 by 3.14, you will see it will be close to 100.5. 9 is D. Okay, here we want to find their circumference. It gives us a circle has a diameter of 28. Again, circumference is equal to pi times diameter. Circumference pi is 3.14. Our diameter is 28. All right, one more time with my reasonableness. 28 is close to 25. 25 times 3 is 75. It's going to be a little bit more than 75. This will have to be 87.9. This is way too much, and these are way too little. 28 is close to 25. 25 is like a quarter. 3 quarters is 75 cents, a little bit more. I will demonstrate the multiplication. 3.14 times 28. 8 times 4 is 32. Carry my 3. 8 times 1 is 8, plus 3 is 11. Carry my 1. 24, 25. Done with the 8. Introduce a 0. 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 1, 2. 2 times 3, 6. 2, 9. 7, 8. Two places behind the decimal, move it here. 87.9, 87.9. So you can see using reasonableness, we can save ourselves a lot of time. All right, going back over our answers. Number 1 was B as in boy. Number 2, B as in boy. Number 4, B as in boy. Number 3, B as in boy. First 4, all B. Number 5, A. 6, C. 7, omit. 8, D. 9, D. 10, C. Count the number of questions that you missed and write it on the top of your quiz. They're worth 10 points apiece.